It's my job to take out the trash. I can't say that's my favorite thing to do, but it's certainly become more fascinating recently. Our family has learned how to deal with our waste and toxics in a much better way.
One of my family's biggest problems is simply our lack of knowledge. It's not like we set out to do any harm, but at the same time, we didn't put any thought into where our waste was going. For example, we didn't know that we had a local recycling system, or the fact that the chemicals we use and the cleaning products we use have a negative impact.
I understand this is your waste for the last week and a half, so 2 weeks?
2 weeks.
Okay, what do we see? We see cardboard, we see food, we see plastic, we see tin cans, we see glass. Okay? And this is a mess. This is garbage. It's disgusting. Okay.
It's garbage.
No, it's garbage. But is it? Isn't glass actually a very valuable resource? Okay. What about these tins? Is that really garbage? Plastic. I mean, we can recycle the plastic. Look at all this plastic we can recycle. If we look at our waste, this is dirty. This is rubbish. This is stuff that we don't want, so we ignore the problem. What I want us to do is to be more proactive. Let's look at having a simple three-bin system, having our rubbish, which should be down to about 10-20%. Okay, very little rubbish. The majority, probably up to, it could be up to 80%, is actually your recycling, which is clean. And then the last little bit is your organic waste, and that can go into your garden. So if we can look at that separating at source right in the kitchen, that'll be perfect.
Okay. So that's the behavior change.
Yes. And is this something that you'd like?
No.
Yes. Because it absolutely stops
this problem.
As a family, we set a goal of recycling 75% of our waste so that it doesn't go to a landfill. We have a new method of managing our waste, and I am in charge of it. It starts in the kitchen where we separate our recyclables from our waste. We wash it, squash it, if needed, before we place it in a special bag. We're one of the lucky homes to have a curbside recycling system where we stay. We take full advantage of that now.
I always thought it was fine to throw your veggies and your grass clippings away, but apparently when organic waste goes to the landfill, it produces methane, which is a harmful greenhouse gas. So now we put all our organic waste into this cute little bucket on top of our kitchen table, and when it gets full, we put it into our compost heap. We now use our compost heap and our new little worm farm much more regularly, and it produces amazing, great quality compost for our garden.
When it comes to cleaning products, I usually choose brands that work well without thinking about the harm that might do to the environment. Now we're using eco-friendly cleaning products, and I'm staying away from products with ammonia, bleach, and strong fragrances. Our new grey water system also needs soap that doesn't have any phosphates in it. I've also invested in some microfiber cloths. They are great for cleaning surfaces without using any soap.
Whenever we repaint our house, my wife chooses the color and I worry about the price. I've never previously considered the contents of the paint or the cost to our health. I have now learned that paint contains volatile organic compounds. Not only is this bad for the environment, it is also not healthy for us to breathe in. Our home has been repainted with non-toxic paints from Breathe Coat. Their EcoGuard exterior paint used here has no VOCs, no lead, and no formaldehyde. So I can enjoy a peace of mind, and we literally live in a greenhouse now.
From now on, it's not only my job to take out the bin, but to make sure that everyone in the home recycles.
And I'll make sure that we only buy environmentally friendly cleaning products.
Why don't you join us on this venture? There's a lot of useful information and advice on the My Green Home website.